Following the murder of the head of the Ndiga clan and director of Transa Electrical, Engineer Daniel Bosa, on 25th February by armed assailants who were traveling on a motorcycle, the Criminal Investigations Division has intensified its hunt for other suspects in the murder. Police spokesperson Fred Enanga disclosed that a total of 7 suspects have since been arrested, including Noah Lujia, who is currently hospitalized after being beaten by a mob, and Mili Naluenda, a clerk in the Uganda Traditional Court.
Now, we are not coming up with the particulars of the 5 suspects, but the case file has been submitted for now to the DPP pending legal guidance who amongst the 5 has incriminating evidence for having participated in the murder plot that targeted and eliminated the victim. Now, together with these 7, together with other perpetrators who are still at large but aggressively pursued, are linked to the ride-along killers of Usero Nkuma Enoch and Lujano. A full account of the preparation meetings, planning, acquisition of killer weapon, hiring of killers, and execution of the murder will be availed in due course.
Also, the police are hunting for Awan Lujia Bosa Tabula, who is also accused of having hatched the murder plan, hired the killer weapon, and went ahead to ensure it was fully executed. A cash bounty has been put up for anyone with credible information leading to the arrest of Lujia.
In the sourcing of the gun, now these are images of Lujia Bosa Tabula, who is wanted for being the prime mastermind behind the murder plot up to its execution. This is one of his photos. Another photo of his is like this.
Engineer Daniel Bosa was shot to death by 3 assailants moving on a motorcycle. At the time of his death, was driving home with his wife. Engineer Daniel Bosa was buried yesterday in Impiji district. In other news, the police are hunting for people behind the kidnapping of children from Nakaseke district and later abandoning them in Chankwanzi district.
You're aware, last week, 2 school children identified as Tusingwire Fiona, aged 4, and Tandeka Patience, aged 5, were allegedly kidnapped by one of the casual workers at their home.
From traffic police, a total of 77 people were killed and over 330 injured in road crashes registered across the country in the past 1 week. Traffic police spokesperson Michael Kananura attributed these crashes to reckless road usage. Kananura reveals that they are yet to relaunch operations against errant motorists in a bid to restore sanity on the roads.
Looked at as a careless overtaking, being in the lead, and followed by speeding. During this week, we intend to carry out the following operations. Operations on errant drivers who have continued to become a problem and are causing most of the road crashes on the roads. And these ones include those who drive on shoulders.
Report compiled by Rachel Nachuala.
It's okay. Yeah, come here.